know there's different things, maybe like five more weeks here, certain days and the planning commission, certain days, do you have those, all that on calendar zone that you know that's available at that time?
No, as a matter of fact, on item 16, we'll discuss the steering, the steering committee in progress and we'll discuss the list.
Okay.
That's all, just kind of the agenda for that.
Okay.
Drew, there's two things you need, meet here and office space. Meet here really.
Don't need a committee.
Right.
Yeah, we can.
Does that need a motion that it's okay for that?
I don't have a problem with the meet here.
How do you mean, the meet here?
But, you know, you have to, you know, Brent will have to look at the calendar on what day is available for them to be.
Usually the evening, anything after five.
Does that need a motion or this?
Looks like a schedule, it's something you need to schedule, you know, I don't understand why that is a issue.
I mean, I'll make a motion that we, you know, they can meet here as far as that goes, but it'll have to coincide with the mayor's parent calendar.
You've also got the jury room.
There's other options too, I don't know if you're aware of this, the library has nice space and we're over at the hospital, there's nice space.
And we're also, no offense intended, but we're having to, each time that we meet in here, we're having air conditioning, heat and electricity. And we have a library over there that is nice and it's underutilized.
$75 just for a deposit and what it's free.
Yeah, I just want to make sure you know about something.
This is a county board.
Exactly, this is not, you know, Jones Farm.
As far as I'm concerned, we can meet somewhere else.
Yeah, and I would still make a motion that go ahead and have to be with us, property management.
I mean, y'all got me confused here.
For the office, for the office, yeah, he can check in by schedule.
I'm just saying, this is a very small committee is what my point is, and you're talking about the dispatch radio for a small committee. It's just a lot of logistics.
The beer board is 30.
Beer board might need to meet over at the library too.
But we pay the library, it can be moved.
We do.
So you're paying for taxpayers over there, you're paying taxpayers over here.
Yeah, I mean, my mom. Yes.
Presume you'll get with Mr. Bush as far as to start out.
Oh, I have a hard time keeping up with all the discussion, so let's have a little, calm down.
What'd you say? Let me know if they come back.
Really, right now, we need to know if it's okay to meet right here for right. Well, if he is going through, Mr. Bush, the schedule, so we've got that part out. Okay, now the office space.
Who made that motion?
I did.
Is there a second?
I second.
So this is usually courthouse?
Yeah.
All right, just call the roll.
Shanae Boyd?
Yes.
Russell Reed?
Yes.
Cory Dillon?
Yes.
Karen Ashford?
Yes.
Jim Bush?
Yes.
Greg Mitchell?
Yes.
Brent Brandon?
Yes.
Randy Gannon?
Yes.
Kim Devonport?
Yes.
Ronnie Mahappy?
Yes.
Motion carried.
There you go. Now, all right, now let's move to the next. There's another portion of this, y'all put it to the part of the committee to review office space. Well, you got to know where you got property at.
Property management committee.
Yeah, that's where we're going to hit.
Office space and storage space.
Yeah, he's looking for space where.
Whatever.
One of the same.
Yes.
Yeah, where you can sit here, hide, and have a place where.
It's basically a secure office stuff, it's not a place where we intend to be.
Me, you've got a place for secure.
I second the motion.
Who made the motion?
To go to Floyd, yeah, to put it to the property management committee. Ms. Floyd?
Yes.
No, you second it? All right.
Shanae Boyd?
No, the name made it, she made it.
I'm seconding.
Go ahead, call the roll.
Shanae?
Yes.
Russell Reed?
No.
Corey Davenport?
No.
Karen Ashford?
Yes.
Jim Bush?
Yes.
Greg Mitchell?
Yes.
Brent Brandon?
Yes.
Randy Gann?
We'll get better at this process, guys.
Yeah, we get frustrated.
Yes.
Jim Davenport?
Yes.
Brian Mahan?
Yes. Thank you, Chris. Thanks. Thank you, sir.
Is, Mr. Sizzle here, is that guy, next item there? Okay? What? One second.
He's coming back, thank you, chief, that was a lot of fun.
Dick, come on up, we got, an ambulance director to address the commission. Everybody able to read the packet, my gentleman, you'll probably have to take that as a grant. We're just reapplying for, excuse me, I should say, reapplying for one grant, which is gonna cost $300.
Can you speak into the microphone, everybody hear you, Dave, I know.
And y'all go again, is it working, is it vibrant?
So the one grant's gonna be for $300 for power loads, is what we call. This is gonna be a reapplication, I wanna understand the grant count that we talked to, which Brent Brandon is also supposed to as well. He had told us the reason why we didn't get it this past year was because he said basically they ran out of money and we missed it by one point. He felt confident that if we reapplied, we would get this grant. That grant is gonna be for $60,000 roughly for the equipment. We're also going to apply for a new ambulance, which is gonna cost $600. And thankfully to the Lions Club, because we won apparently a battle of the badges, which thank you to the Lions Club and thank you to everyone who voted for us. That $600, we actually received a $600 donation, a $600 check. So instead of that actually coming out of our budget, we were just gonna use that money to buy the new truck. And if you look on page six, about midway down, it actually says when we apply for these two grants, it's that, all the first period, it says when serving a jurisdiction of 20,000 residents or fewer, that will show that we make available non-federal funds in an amount equal to not less than 5%. That's what the county's gonna be responsible for with both these grants is 5%, because we're obviously less than 20,000. And if you look there on page seven, it says the application submission deadline, it's gonna be the 26th of this month. And again, Brent Brandon has spoken with this gentleman that does the grant, so he could probably answer just as many questions as I can, and not more, so. This is just to let you guys keep you in the loop and.
The deadline is what?
The 26th.
And also, you're looking for 5% of the $146,000, right?
Correct. If we receive.
Deal. And how much is that, 5%?
Hold on. Yeah, what now? 5% of $146,000, it'd be $7,500.
Yeah.
Well, that'd be a lot less than us having to pay for all.
Yeah, that's what we're doing, we're just exploring new avenues, trying to.
Right.
Well. I understand that, and looking at y'all's cash flow sheet, I realize these are old numbers.
But, y'all can bluff that $7,500.
That's what we'll do, you guys.
I mean, they can do it within their department.
Without anybody. Right, he just wanted to bring it to, let y'all know that he wants to apply for the grant.
What I'm getting at.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
I mean, we're not looking at new money that we're gonna have to spend.
Right.
If they stay in the budget.
Right.
How many you have in your budget for a new ambulance?
It was $130,000.
$116,000 and $117,000, I think.
That's what the cost was, if we would have tag teamed with Rutherford County, but unfortunately, I think that vote has saved.
What's the deadline on this grant?
26th.
For this one?
This month, 26th.
Brent has spoken with this grant?
No, ma'am, no. Brent has spoken with the grant writer.
Who is the grant writer?
Jeff Tinsley.
Go ahead, Dave.
No, it's Jeff Tinsley, he's out of Overton County. I was gonna say, does Brent actually got a 40K?
So he's not like from Upper Cumberland or?
Yeah, Overton County, Upper Cumberland.
Okay, so is there a fee for this grant if you get it or not get it? Is there any kind of?
Yes, ma'am, $600 is to go get to the new truck grant.
Do I need the grant writer, is there a fee?
That's the fee included.
That is.
$600, and that's what I was explaining, that we had got actually the $600 from the line above. And we were just gonna take that money and use it for it, but you're coming out of the budget. Now, the $300 would, because in this budget, what it was that there wasn't any money appropriated for grants. So it was added, instead of keep you guys in the loop, and we were just gonna transfer $300, I think, out of, Diane, I said, I think, out of the in-service training line.
You have to pay that grant writer regardless whether you get the grant or not.
Correct.
I'm like motion, like.
But, yeah.
I'm sorry.
No, no, that's fine. In actually, looking at current cash flow, we're going back. Our projection for September was $67,500 cash receipts. Actually, $47,200. So we're actually $20,000 under budget on cash flow receipts. End of the month, we projected to be $74,760. We're actually projected $67,165, or reality, sorry, not projected. We actually ended at $67,165. So revenue is coming short based on the budget in ambulance service. So you're talking about additional expenditure, and revenue's going the wrong way.
I'm like motion, we're approved to write the grant.
With, can you modify that with the understanding that it will come out of their line?
Well, I mean, if they're short on their budget, they won't have to put some money.
You make which one, what money do you make?
The $75,000.
Which is paid just when you get the grant, right?
If you get the grant.
If you.
Yeah, it's all we need to do right now is approve it and move $300. Yeah.
That's all I'm making a motion for him to apply for grant.
Well, and that's good. Just need to be aware and keep it on the radar screen, that for sure, and all of us, that's gonna be approving or disapproving. If revenues continue to go the way they are, folks, you're going backwards. And you may say $300 is not much, you may say $7,500 is not much, you may say $10,000 is not much, or $100,000 is not much. But folks, this additional revenue, that as of this moment, I don't know where you get it from. I don't know what department you have.
Right, take that out of $130,000.
This budget.
Yes.
That's already been put in there.
But I think what you're saying is that on black pad, you're on more than that on black pad.
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
I get that, I understand that.
They put in this, first this in the debt service fund, we put $100,000+ in there and charged the taxes to the people, and that's been sitting there for how many years now? I think that's where you're gonna come up with your $7,500, if they can't do it out of the budget.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
He's talking about the money that's in debt services that.
That we taxed the citizens four years ago, because contrary to what we just spent money.
Take a look at debt service, yeah.
It's still there.
But you can only spend that on debt.
Exactly.
Turn it out to a capital outlay.
Just keep it on the radar screen.
I say Karen's motion.
Okay, so we got motion on the table to apply for a grant for the ambulance service.
It'll be at least October before you know whether you got it or not.
I was probably, in fact, I think on this.
Probably later than that.
Karen made the motion, and Brandon seconded. Okay, any other discussion?
Is it 100%, Brandon?
5%.
5%.
5% of that.
Yes.
5%.
$7,500.
Around $7,300.
And like I said, we're just looking for new ways to grant and stuff like that, too, you know, obviously try to help as much.
If we don't have.
So, go ahead.
No, I don't know if it's appropriate to say that.
No, it is, go ahead.
Is this something that if that we find out that we are not able to have the money, will we be able to go ahead and just not take the grants or anything? But it's a FEMA grant, is what I was looking at.
Now, that, I'll be on, I don't know.
You're just limited, so I don't know.
Well, you know, and given what Mr. Mahaffey's saying, yes, you know, there is kind of a down. But if y'all can stay just constant the way it's going, of course, these are old figures, this is not counting the 24,000 that'll be coming up in October. So even with that said, you're still projecting $112,000. Okay, at the end of the year. So if y'all can keep your expenses down and that, then there shouldn't be no problem.
Any other discussion? So everybody clear on the motion? Call roll.
Janine Boyd?
Yes.
Russell Reed?
Yes.
Cory Davidson?
Yes.
Karen Asher?
Yes.
Jim Bush?
Yes.
Greg Mitchell?
Yes.
Brent Brandon?
Yes.
Randy Gannon?
You have $130,000 in your budget right now to buy for a new ambulance, right?
No.
It's served.
It's served.
Okay.
Was that?
Was.
Was.
Where'd it go?
It was divided up when we done the budget the last year.
They pulled 18 and they pulled 17.5 cents out.
Jim Davenport?
Yes.
Ronnie Mahaffey?
No.
9-4-1, yes.
Okay, Dave, got anything else? No, I just want to play by the way, he said as soon as we found out, he needed to know because of the deadline, so we're clear, we're in contact.
Now, hold on. You had something else about the ambulances.
Oh, the lead. And that Jason, which you could probably understand, is more, go ahead.
Is deleting the two units that are out of warranty. He had gotten a bid on those, but I think he wants to delay that now since we have 804 is down. They want to put the rear end.
All right, I need to ask you one question on this. Now, Ricky Cope come to us a time before. Now, are you in contact with the EPA that you can do this?
We have a copy of the letter. They have given it to you.
Yeah.
Saying that, yes, you could delete.
Now, is this Rutherford County and not us?
What I understand is a general letter that Rutherford County just made a copy of. But that's why I say I wish Jason was here because he had that information. Jason is the one that is in charge of our truck maintenance. But again, just like Brady said, we're going to hold off because until we get the rear end fixed on 804, which is our newest truck, just to play it safe, which the money's already there in our maintenance budget, but just to play it safe, we're going to hold on probably a little bit until we find out the cost of 804. And if worst case scenario, we can rest on a year, and as long as that, we're going to get to stay in our budget.
Well, I mean, I understand what you're saying about Rutherford County, which Rutherford County is a bigger operation. So what really I would like y'all to do is to make sure that you're within the guidelines of the EPA because they're touching on your deficit.
They can get it specific for Ford County.
Right, Ford County, Rutherford County stuff. It might not have been part of it.
Like I said, from my knowledge, it was a general letter that they had just got right off of us. Yes, so we'll make sure the board and which Brent is over the ambulance committee and we can discuss like I said.
I need to make some administrative announcements. First of all, Mike Ford is here, and he needs to conduct the order. So right now, 11:45, Mike Ford needs to sit down with us for a closed-door session for the upcoming pending litigation. We also have a appointment with the jail crew coming in at 1 p.m., and I just don't know how we can get there. What I'm trying to say is that without making a motion, we recommend that we probably break recess at another time later on in the afternoon. We do have some other things on this agenda. I was hoping we could get through it. I don't see how we can get through it. Am I right, Mike? I need to lay out some things to us in private session.
I'm just going to ask you some questions.
With all due respect, instead of coming back this evening, can we come back to that next week?
We'll just make sure we
cover where we're at, let's see,
Mr. Chairman, if I may, can we do the quarterly reports, the highway chairman and myself would like to do a quarterly report, possible report, we doing a recess session?
The recent, we really want that.
No, I'm serious.
So y'all want to recess until afternoon? Usually a recess is trying to do it within the day.
So this is a suggestion? I'm fine with leaving it too, if you need to do that.
Yeah, but you want to do it at 2:00? That'll be fine, if you want to do it at 2:00.
You will go over to the check.